I told you nylon is prepared without using any natural raw material. Okay, now how is it prepared from? It is prepared from the coal, water and air. All of them are natural, but it is actually a raw material as such. Okay, it is not like something that we obtain from plants or animals. Okay, so nylon is a said to be an absolutely man-made. Okay, so don't get confused. Again, I'm telling you, water, air and coal are natural, but they are not something that they are obtained from plants and animals. Okay, all right. Now nylon is a very strong fiber. It is elastic and it is absolutely light. It is lustrous as well as it is easy to wash. It is easily washed. We can use nylon for many things, such as socks, ropes, tents, toothbrushes, car seat belts, curtains, belts, sleeping bags, etc. And as I said, it is also used for rock climbing ropes. Now come to the polyester. Polyester is another synthetic fiber. And यहाँ पे क्या होता है कि दिस फाइबर इसकी खासियत होती है कि दे इनमें रिंकल्स नहीं होता. तो आपने देखा होगा, आपके स्कूल जाने से पहले आप अपनी शर्ट और स्कर्ट और पैंट को प्रेस करते हो. सो इफ अगर पॉलिस्टर की शर्ट होगी तो उसको प्रेस करने की जरूरत नहीं होगी, क्योंकि उसमें रिंकल ही नहीं होगा. ठीक है, सो पॉलिस्टर के साथ देर इज अ एक अलग चीजों को मिला सकते हो. ओके, देन देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड पॉलीकॉट. वट इज पॉलीकॉट? पॉलिस्टर प्लस कॉटन. सो पॉलिस्टर प्लस कॉटन मिक्स करा, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड पॉलीकॉट. एंड पॉलीवुल, इसमें अगर वूल मिक्स कर दिया. सो पॉलिस्टर इज ऑल्सो अ वेरी इट्स अ नाइस थिंग टू यूज. विद वट हैपन विद पॉलिस्टर, इट रिमेन्स क्रिस्प एंड इज ईजी टू वॉश. इट ठीक है, एंड इट इज सुटेबल फॉर मेकिंग ड्रेस मटीरियल. वी हैव स्टार्टेड प्रेफरिंग सिंथेटिक फाइबर ओवर नेचुरल फाइबर बिकॉज इट आर लाइट एंड ईजी एंड चीप. सो एनी काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स यू वॉन्ट ड्रेसेस, बिकॉज आई सेड पॉलीकॉट इज अ मिक्सअप ऑफ कॉटन एंड पॉलिस्टर. यू कैन ऑल्सो मिक्स इट विद वूल. सो इट इज़ वेरी ईजी. देन यू हैव टेरिलिन. टेरिलिन इज अ पॉपुलर पॉलिस्टर. इट इज़ क्वाइट पॉपुलर पॉलिस्टर विच इज़ एक्सट्रीमली यूज इन फाइन फाइबर्स एंड इट कैन बी वोवन इन टू यार्न. सो इट इज़ यूज प्रिटी मच अ लॉट ऑफ प्लेसेस. नाउ वट वी आर गोना टॉक अबाउट PET. PET इज अ वेरी फैमिलियर फॉर्म ऑफ पॉलिस्टर. I'm pretty sure that you would have seen in your plastic bottles that the bottom of the it is written PET. Just take a look at it. That PET is the one that is used for making bottles or utensils or wires and a lot of other things. So PET is a type of polyester which is used in a lot of things. All right, now moving on, acrylic. What is acrylic? Acrylic is used in sweaters and shorts. It is like a wool. And again, it is cheaper version of wool. It is not wool, cheaper version of wool. Although it is not made from natural wool. So these are prepared from another type of synthetic fiber called acrylic. So what happened? Acrylic wool material are obtained from prepared from acrylic. Now what happened, the wool obtained from natural sources is quite expensive. Like I said, acrylic is a cheaper version of wool. Okay, now moving on, let's understand the characteristics of a synthetic fiber, or you can say the properties. First of all, it is cheap. Silk is very expensive, but rayon is cheap. Wool is expensive, but acrylic is cheap. So you understand that these are stay for a level. Now second is durable. They are easy to wash. They can go for a long time. It can be made in a variety of colors. whatever you color you want, you can make into that color. Now you all know, do know that anything that is there, nothing comes without disadvantages. Okay, so there is also disadvantages, and we will discuss about it. They catches fire. So it is not advisable that if you are cooking or something, you should wear a synthetic fire. Okay, and the second is melt on heating. Now we're gonna talk about plastics. So plastic is also a polymer. Okay, like the synthetic fiber, which is there is a one monomer which is continuously repeating. That is plastic. Plastic is like a synthetic fiber. It also has a polymer like a synthetic fiber. Now there are plastic articles that are available that we are constantly use in our daily life. Why? Because they are easily moldable. You can give them any shape or size, and they are quite handy. Okay, plastics can be recycled, reused, colored, melted, etc. It is not a property which is easily available for us. So plastic get deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as thermoplastic. There is a type of plastic which is known as thermoplastic, which you if you heat it, what happens, it can deform. Okay, it can be in different forms easily on heating, and you can bend them easily. So basically they are flexible, and these type of plastics are known as thermoplastics. Cool. Now there are plastic which are when you mold it cannot be softened by heating. These are called thermosetting plastic. So what is the major difference between thermoplastic and thermosetting plastic? When you just heat them, they can bend easily, but about thermosetting plastic, you have molded it, they cannot be softened by heating, and those are known as thermosetting plastics. Clear? Moving on, what are the positive and negative aspects of plastics? So plastics are lightweight, durable, lower price, non-reactive, and poor conductor of heat and electricity. Okay, now these are the positive aspects. Now if I'm gonna talk about the negative aspects, it is non-biodegradable. It is non-biodegradable, and plastic pollution, it doesn't degrade, stay on earth forever and forever, and it is quite a serious problem. Plastic pollution is quite a serious problem. So what can we do? What are the causes of this plastic pollution? Is that burning of plastic, it take it several years to decompose. We kept throwing plastic into water bodies here and there. So water bodies, and these are the ones which are causing the plastic pollution. Now how do we prevent it? We can prevent it by following the 5 R. Now what are the 5 R? First of all is reduce the usage of plastic. Now then recycle it and recover it, refuse. These are the 5 R's. Say no to plastic. So these are the 5 R's to make sure that plastic pollution doesn't happen. And that's all guys about this this chapter. I have already covered all the important topic of this chapter. Okay, and if there is any confusion you have, you can ask me in a group. Okay, thank you.